Do you feel like Procreate has some secret tips and tricks that are deeply unknown to you?
Hi, I'm Bobbo and I draw a lot of the time on Procreate. And today I'm gonna show you my tips and tricks how to draw more quickly and efficiently using Procreate. So the next time you're drawing for hours in the middle of the night, well, it will be your art and not the programs, because you will know these tips and tricks. Hashtag I'm an artist and existence is pain.
We're going to start with a quick menu. I assume most of you know it because it's really a time saver. But for those of you who don't, let's set it up and I forbid you to draw without it. Go to the settings and go to preferences and then gesture controls. From there, you can select the quick menu, and here you can choose how you want the quick menu to pop on the screen. I choose touch. And now when I touch the screen, the menu pops up. The options are pretty random, but if you hold the tab, there's another menu that comes up, and from there you can choose whatever action you want, even brushes that you use the most. That's assuming you know the name of the brushes, something that I can do. Quick menu will save you a ton of time with the repeating actions. When I draw characters, I flip a lot. And before, I was going to the canvas options and flipping from there. But now, I've set it up in my quick menu and with two touches, I flip the canvas. It's so much easier and it saves a lot of time. And yeah, you can set another things. I also set the transparency of my layers because I usually play with that a lot, and I set up clear layer, but yeah, you can set up whatever you like. Okay, now we all have quick menus and we are ready for the next tip. The next thing that I'm using a lot, aka the second tip, is the reference layer. Right now we have the sketch. The lines are really cool, we like them a lot, and we're creating a layer underneath about her skin. The old way in which I was coloring my art was to create shapes, like closed shapes, which then I fill by dragging. And because I'm drawing mostly with texture brushes, there were white lines and I had to fix them up, but that was the quickest way for me to draw. We are not going to do that anymore, because we are going to use a reference layer. Go to your sketch, and from the menu, you are changing it to reference layer. Then, when you drag, look at what happens. It filled the shape with color, even though we are on another layer, and not on the sketch layer. It's really cool. I mean, it's amazing. It's magic. But beware. You must have your sketch fully closed, because if it's not closed, look at what happens. It spills the color everywhere. It's a mess. It's like my room. And we don't want this to happen. So, be sure that your sketch is closed if you want to use that method. And why not use that method? Use it.
Do it.
Tip 3, clipping masks. Right now, I want to add details on her hair, like gradient, for example. Let's see. I'm picking my color, and when I try to draw, it will spill everywhere. One way to avoid that is to select the main color of the hair, and on a new layer on top of it, to draw within the selection. And that's a way, but we're going to use a clipping mask. So, the layer on top, we're going to transform into clipping mask, and then, when we draw, magic, it won't spill the color out of the shape of the hair. Let's add shine on the hair clips. We're making a layer on top of the color of the hair clips and making it a clipping mask. And then we just draw like there's no tomorrow. We don't have to worry about going out of the lines or out of the shape, because the clipping mask is restricting the spill. Before using clipping masks, separate all your main covers on different layers. And then just clip a lot of layers on which you add the details. That's the magic of the clipping masks. Clearly, if you go to my old videos, you see that I didn't know about that magic because one drawing took me hours to color. Tip number 4 is the selection tool. And I know that you know what is a selection tool, but hear me out. There are a few things that can come in handy. We already know that when we are selecting, we can click and create straight lines or draw the selection. But, for example, I want to cover the eye. The menu for the selection goes away. So, what I'm doing is holding the selection icon and the menu pops up again. Then I can select the other eye and cover it. Another cool thing is that you can regulate the mask visibility of your selection. Go to the preferences and then you have a selection mask. And in percent, you can choose whatever you like. Tip number 4 or tip 5, I don't know, I gave up on math a long time ago. The option about the last used cover. So for example, I want to change the hair clip. I'm making it purple. Then I want to draw the other one like yellow. Now again, I want to draw with purple and I can tap on it. But another way is to hold the cover circle and it will switch to the previous used cover. Now I will continue drawing. You guys can tell me in the comments if that video was helpful, if I explained it well enough. You can subscribe to the channel. We passed 200 subscribers, I can't believe, and I'm very thankful. If you're not a subscriber, why are you not in the gang? Subscribe to the channel.
Do it.
Give me ideas. What should I do next? And you can find me on Instagram. I post a lot of my illustration time lapses from Procreate there. And yeah, I think that's it for now.